Hello, my name is Evangelia Avramidou and I will talk to you about epigenetics and genetics and revealing the secrets beyond genes above, a holistic way to cope with climatic changes. In 1809, Jean-Baptiste Lamarck published his theory, in which he described a two-part mechanism by which change was gradually introduced into the species and passed down through generations. According to Lamarck's theory, a given giraffe could, over a lifetime of straining to reach high branches, develop an elongated neck, and this neck was inherited in the next generation. Forest trees, as we all know, are complex organisms which nowadays are facing threats under climate change, diseases, and attacks from insects and pathogens. Their ability to adapt to these changing environments depends on their genetic and epigenetic integrity and the relationship between them. But what is epigenetics? Epigenetics is defined as a mechanism that regulates gene expression without change in sequence DNA, in the sequence of DNA. There are three main epigenetic mechanisms: DNA methylation, which is the addition of a methyl group in a cytosine, and the modification of histones and the macroRNAs. But why epigenetics is important in forestry? Because if we know the regulatory mechanisms involving the adaptive epigenetic responses, we may help to guide the management of genetic resources in plant breeding, especially in long-lived forestries, where changes in allele frequencies are expected to occur very slowly. Source of variations can be stochastic epimutations, which are triggered by environment during a lifetime, when new phenotypes could be crucial for population survival. And the interface between genotype and environment, the overall rate of epimutation is much higher than that of a genetic mutation. Many studies have shown that if an environmental stress is maintained long enough, epigenetic alterations can reach equilibrium frequencies and transmit it in next generations. Today we will talk about five axes: the genetics and the relationship with epigenetics, epigenetics and heritability, epigenetics and speciation, monitoring epigenetics and adaptation, and epigenetics and conservation. Richards in the 2006 stated that there are two possible extreme cases for the interaction between genetic variation and epigenetic DNA methylation. Epigenetic variation can be strongly associated with genetic variation, and epigenetic variation is completely uncoupled from genetic variation. We conducted a study in 2015 for Prunus avium natural populations, and we found that epigenetic variation was completely uncoupled from genetic variation. We found also relatively low epigenetic diversity in wild cherry that did not differ significantly from the corresponding genetic diversity value. Then we found very weak epigenetic population differentiation in contrast to the high genetic differentiation. Also, a non-significant correlation between geographic and epigenetic distances further indicated the absence of strong effects due to regional epigenetic diversity. My et al. Conducted also a study for Populus tomentosa. They studied nine natural populations of Chinese white poplar. And results showed that also epigenetic and genetic variation did not completely match. They found also related methylation, non-methylation levels significantly different among the nine populations. The genome methylation presented tissue-specific characteristics, and the methylation level in xylem was higher than in leaves. And the genome methylation in the xylem shows great epigenetic variation and could be fixed and inherited through mitosis. We proceed for epigenetics and heritability. We studied a full sheep family of Cypressa berberis with 382 progeny, and we found that maternal inheritance was higher than paternal. This phenomenon is also studied in humans, where they found that maternal methylation maternal inheritance of methylation is higher also in humans. Total methylation presented a mean of 28% and was higher than the mean parent value. The Mendelian inheritance was low, and we found the novomethylation in the progeny higher. We found also a correlation between CNG methylation with height and diameter, while total methylation and CG methylation were positively correlated only with height. In another study for Pistacia lentiscus, according to Abaladejo et al., the results showed that they found higher levels of related DNA methylation in mother plants than in their offspring, a higher epigenetic structure among families that was decoupled to the genetic structure, and a significant relationship between the related DNA methylation levels and sibling phenotypic trait variation, with higher levels of methylation in the genome being associated to a poorer performance. In Norway spruce, a team of researchers from Skorpa, Jonsen, and Yakovlev, they found the temperature-dependent epigenetic memory from the time of embryo development, which therefore after influences the timing of bulk phenology and gene expression. This is important because we see here that there is an epigenetic memory of climatic conditions in the embryo during development in the mother tree. For epigenetics and speciation, a really nice study was conducted from Lira Mendeiros et al. For the mangrove tree, and they found that in contrasting habitats, they found different morphological traits, and the epigenetic variation was greater than genetic variation within and between populations based on analysis of DNA sequences and methylation patterns. According to Revolo et al., transposable elements which are plenty in forest trees are responsible for rapid genome remodeling, play significant role in speciation. Transposable elements are able to induce speciation through chromosomal rearrangements. Since chromosomal rearrangements are able to induce speciation, bursts of transposable elements transposition can cause chromosomal rearrangements, and bursts of transposable elements transposition may be driven by the selective release of active elements as the result of an epigenetic response to the environment. And moving forward, for monitoring epigenetics and adaptations, in Nuvercus lobata, Guggier et al. Found with a next generation sequencing epigenetic markers stronger association with climate than equivalent neutral genetic markers. This is so the adaptive role of DNA methylation in climatic changes. Also in Poplar, from a study that it was published in PNAS in 2011, they studied the lasting effect of clone history. They took cuttings of the same genotype from different geographic locations and grown under common environmental conditions. And then the transcriptome response after drought was studied. Genotypes with the longest time since establishment and last common propagation showed the most pronounced location-specific patterns in transcriptome and DNA methylation, indicating a possible epigenomic basis for a clone history-dependent transcriptome divergence. Recently, for epigenetics and conservation, Ray et al. Published a paper which highlights the importance of conservation epigenetics. They show that DNA methylation and developmental reprogrammation that we can be considered as an additional conservation level, a so-called conservation epigenetics. They highlight four steps in order to accomplish a roadmap to accomplish conservation epigenetics. The first step is the development of biomarkers, epimarkers, the study of wild population ecological structuring, the improvement of population reinforcement strategies through conservation translocation, and the study of landscape functional connectivity. So until now, we know that epigenetic variation can occur in natural populations, ecotypes, and species, can correlate with naturally occurring phenotypic variation, and there is a potential role in adaptation and evolution. We must focus on understanding epigenetic processes in an ecological context and uncover the adapting function of phenotypic plasticity and transgenerational stress memory through epigenetics, which requires joint analysis of the functional phenotype, the population genetic structure, and epigenetic variation. Thank you very much for your attention.